After watching the videos on the theory of the consolidation of soil, in this video we'll be dealing with the problems based on this unit. Most of the problems will be based on finding out the settlement of soil under some overburden pressure or due to the construction of any structure. Some problems will be dealing with the lab edometer test, or also called as one-dimensional consolidation test. Here you can see a saturated clay layer subjected to some stress delta sigma. If we take a small element into the clay layer and enlarge it, you can see a two-phase system. Soil solids and voids filled with fluid. In most of the cases it will be water. So going to the basics, the definition of voids ratio E is VV by VS. Based on the definition, VV can be represented as E and VS as 1. So the total height can be given as 1 plus E naught. Now, if the same element is under a stress, so there will be a deformation. So as soil solids won't deform, so water will be squeezed out according to the consolidation theory. So the volumetric strain delta V upon V, if you divide it by the unit area on both the sides, will get it as delta H upon H. So relating it to the two phase diagram, we can get it as delta H upon H equals to delta E upon 1 plus E naught. So this E naught is nothing but the initial voids ratio, or the voids ratio at level 1. So similarly, you can write different equations. Always remember, the E initial or the E1 will be greater than the final voids ratio. Just putting more light on the previous slide, as understanding of this concept is very important in solving the problems. So under deformation, you will have the voids ratio shifting from E initial to E final. So again, the same ratio, delta E upon 1 plus E naught, or E initial equals to delta H upon H. Sometimes it will be E initial, E final, or E1 or E2. Quickly, we'll have a revision of Terzaghi's equation. As you have studied, we have this basic differential equation. In this, our aim is to find CV. The formula for CV is given by K upon gamma W MV. As K and gamma W are well known to you, MV is the coefficient of volume compressibility, and the formula for MV is given. The same can be found out by the edometer. Here you can see the plots given by the lab edometer test. Both the graphs are drawn using the same data. The only difference in the plots is the x-axis. On the first graph, it's a normal scale graph, whereas the second plot is a similar graph. The x-axis is in the log scale. As you can see in the first graph, you can see a curve, whereas in the second plot, you can see a straight line. The slope of this line in the first graph is called as AV, whereas the slope of the line in the second plot is called as CC. So to find the slope in the problems, generally you will be given the values of E and sigma. So E1 and E2 and sigma 1 and sigma 2 will be given. Sigma 1 plus additional delta sigma will be sigma 2, also sometimes referred as sigma initial and sigma final. So the formula for AV is nothing but the slope delta E by delta sigma. From AV you can find the value of MV, whereas in the second plot the value of CC can be found out by the slope delta E upon delta of the log value sigma. This is another form to explain CC. In this slide, you can see the settlement. Most of the problems we will be dealing with will be related to the settlement of the clay layer. In this settlement, generally the amount of settlement and the time taken for the settlement is important. One of the important parameters here is U, which is nothing but the consolidation ratio or degree of consolidation, which is the ratio of the settlement at any given time t upon the settlement or the ultimate settlement. It can be calculated using the formula mv into sigma into h. Also, delta h can be found using the formula using the lab data. This is an important point which will help you to understand the problems. The ultimate settlement is not affected by the nature of drainage, whether it is one way or two way. However, the time rate of settlement depends upon the nature. This nature of drainage, one way or two way, will be explained in the next slide. Time factor Tv is given as Cv into T upon T square. It has different formula for U less than 60 and for U greater than 60%. In this slide, you can see two figures. In the first one, there's a clay layer. Above it is a permeable layer. It may be ground surface or a sand layer. Beneath it is an impermeable or a rock layer. So when there is a stress applied, you can imagine that the water will try to come out only from the top. So there is called as one way or single drainage. Whereas in the other figure, you can see both the sides, on the top and the above, we have a permeable layers. So the water will try to go out from the both the sides. So in this case, we call it double drainage because it will be going on the two sides. So the first is single drainage. In that case, your D value will be equal to the height h. In the second case, if it is a double drainage, then the D value will be h by 2. This is a slide containing all the important formulae required to solve the problems. Most of them are interrelated. So take some time, pause the video and try to understand the interrelationships, which will be helpful for solving the problem. So we'll be starting with the first problem. It states that in the lab consolidation test, the following results were obtained. When the load was changed from 50 to 100, the void ratio decreased from 0.7 to 0.65. We are supposed to find MV and CC. So writing down the given data, the E1 or the E initial or E naught. In this problem, we'll use the notation E1, which is 0.7, for sigma 1 is 50. And when the sigma 2 was changed or increased to 100, the E2 value is 0.65. We are supposed to find MV and CC. So the very next step is to write down the formulas related to MV and CC in the form of E and sigma. So MV formula is AV upon 1 plus E naught, and the CC formula is E1 minus E2 upon log of sigma 2 by sigma 1. Now the AV formula is unknown, so the AV formula is delta E by delta sigma. Now the picture is very clear. We have the values for all the unknowns. So we'll start with AV. Using the formula, if you put all the values, you'll get the value as 0.001 meter square per kilonewton. Now you look at the units, it is nothing but the inverse of the unit of stress. As you see the formula of AV, it is delta E by delta sigma. So the rate of delta is unitless and the sigma stress comes in denominator. So the unit of AV becomes the inverse of the stress. Same formula applies to MV. AV upon 1 plus E naught. So you'll get the value as 5.88 into 10 to the power minus 4. Same unit again, meter square per kilonewton. The last one is CC. It is unitless. Using this above formula, you'll get the value as 0.116. So with this, we finish with the first basic problem.